Before this video begins, I will be leaving the timestamps for the full guide on each site. If you don't want to hear like the commentating or the tips, just go ahead and skip to the timestamp below and please enjoy the video. Hello everybody, my name is Afieno. We're going to be looking at Chalet Attack. So, my Twitch chat has been recommending this for me. People usually have a hard time attacking, trophy, kitchen, maybe even master games. So, I'm going to be showing you guys usually what I do, and it works out about most of the time. All right, I'm just going to go shotgun. Usually, let's load in real quick. So usually, I leave my drone to, go get the hatches. So I'm using Hibana, and with Hibana, she can do so much stuff on this map. So I usually leave my drone right here, but usually when I spawn in, I watch for spawn peaks. The white garage right here, usually got vigil on crack, as King Jor says, wants to run out. Get my impact here. While watching for the spawn peak right here, people like to usually break it open a little bit. You don't have to worry so much about up here, because don't be that guy that walks and tries to vault on this. There's no point of going atop this rock, unless you're trying to load a Hakuna Matata, whatever this shit is. If you're just gonna go in here, you're gonna lose maybe 1 HP. You'll lose an HP, and you're risking yourself to get spawn peaked, and you don't want to die as Heartbreach. So, again, yes, I know I'm going Heartbreach. People don't like going Hibana, but Hibana is actually an upcoming frag op. So, once you get up, usually I run down this way, go from spawn, you run up this way, shoot the default cam. You can't really get spawn peek from anyone here unless some monkey runs out right at the trophy window, which he'll immediately get traded out unless your teammates are good. So, pick up your drone. I usually leave it right here. You don't have to worry about this too much. So, I just rappel. And then, kind of go up sound a little bit. And then people will run out. But after that, you throw. You don't peek it. No. You don't peek this. You put your drone up here. You throw it off the chimney. You want to master that. You go here. Again. Throw it right up the chimney. Your drone will land right here. And it is completely safe unless some guys peeking on the window. Which I doubt they would do at a high rank. But, kind of do it up here. You get a little scope it out. And then you stay right here, you drone out for the feet. You don't see no feet anywhere. Some people with a Valkyrie might be here, behind the bed, so you want to drone yourself out. You can go to a bathroom, you don't have to go right here. All you have to do is just, jump your drone up here, look around, you don't see nobody. Check behind the bed. Drone right here. At this point, when it is clear right here, maybe do a quick scan in the office. Check behind the desk. And just general stuff. You don't have to drone the whole second floor out. Just enough for you to get into master bedroom safe. See, you could even stop right here, to be honest. Depends how close you are, but if you're right here, you gotta get up. You gotta shoot open the barricade. You're probably reloading now. A lot can happen in that 3 seconds, and a Jaeger or someone could be flanking. You might want to watch out for nitros. But this may sound like a lot, but I'm breaking everything down. That way you guys can execute it and rewatch this video if you need to. You kind of get back in your drone. I like to leave it right here, so safely so we can get back. Watch out for any you don't have to worry about Val cams too much. Maybe just I'll watch out for the C4 though when you walk close to here, because someone might be the double door, throw a C4. After you drone that out, then this is open. Pull out your Hibana. Quick. You back off a little bit. And punch open this window. Kind of get a low angle. You just kind of hold this for a bit. Once it opens, watch out though, holding this, because the Valkyrie does like to C4 this from kitchen and toss it up. Maybe we try to deny it, but you gotta watch out for C4s most of the time we're doing this. And then always keep your aware 75% of your attention on here and 25 over here. So maybe just subconsciously, all right, gotta do a little check-in. Is anybody up here? All right. So if there's someone up here, you might want to try, go office, library window, kind of just deal with them based on the situation where your teammates are doing. But if not, I usually just recharge right here. This leads into, you can see people in trophy. Now people, oh, drone hole, you don't want to get shot from the window. 99% of the time, no one's going to be, up there. They're going to be hiding over here. You might be hold this angle for at least like 20 seconds. I guarantee you, if you see someone's foot, you might be able to get a little tagged, but this is where it happens. People will wait until they get a clear shot, but people aren't going to be standing right there. So you always have to be 100% reactant to this. And if you see a foot, you shoot your trigger as fast as you can. Get a little tag, and then you might be able to get a kill. So after that, you can either go over here, get to like, you know, under the kitchen. You could make your way into, you know, you could make your way into offices. Obviously, you don't want to go for the shotgun most of the time. You could, you know, recharge up here, get the person hiding like a maestro or echo in here. Then you blow up a recharge. None of that, or you can get like, oh, the time. What the? There's a time limit? What the? Okay, I'll come back here in a second just to finish up the round. Okay, actually, no. No, you just recharge this. 5 seconds. And then, so that's basically the second floor thing. Here, we'll hold there. And after that, punch, punch here. I usually pre-fire this. And then this is usually closed off, but if it's open, then no matter. Then you throw a drone down. You open this up. You know what? You don't want to mag dump. If you mag dump, you're going to get ran out on, most likely, sometimes. You know, drone set. Okay. No bandit charge on the wall. If there is a bandit charge, then, or a K charge, then you might want to try to get from below. Ask someone. Alright, most of the time, don't even bother, but if it's most likely not going to be banded. So you get your Habanas. Boom. You get the rat corner out. Remember what we were talking about, the angle from above? That one guy in trophy is always going to be hiding, like, right here. Or, like, right here. Then, boom, he's already exposed. He has nowhere to go. If you have someone here, catch the window, the guy in trophy is dead, and you kind of get it for free. Now, when I say free, I don't mean run your ass in here, because there's the rotation right here. But by the time, trophy should be pretty cleared out, and, you know, maybe kitchen, or might be roam. The roamers are starting to come back to site. They'll be like, yo, we gotta need you on site. So you can catch a flanker up here, or, you know, coming through the double doors. It's pretty self-explanatory. But yeah, that's basically it for the kitchen, and you're asking, how do I get the plant? How do I get this? If you do have the diffuser, and depends how many people are alive, you could either full sprint if your teammates are here, but you want to be careful, you're really exposed. It really depends where your teammates are. Either that, you could rotate all the way around, and then jump in this window. You know, kind of pre-fire this. It's just like really self-defendant. If you're the last one alive, you shouldn't worry too much about it. You know, it's just like, yo. Just take the L at that point. It's fine, because this is not guaranteed to work every round. You know, you get the plant down, you just go from here. You try to get the last kill. So that's basically it for the kitchen defense. Let's move on to the basement defense. Next bomb site, we're going down to wine and garage. Now, this is a very, very a pretty balanced site, to be honest. Either defenders, if they play well, then attackers, and obviously they're gonna win. But you know, what your job is as a solo queue is to do as much as you can to get the upper hand on the other team, as much as you can do. And what can you do to make it so that, like, you know, to make just make stir up the enemy defense? So they'll say they're down the stairs. You know, usually wherever you are, you have your drone. Remember I said, keep your drones alive. You presuppose it right here. You could probably just shoot this down, go behind that tree, you know, drone yourself in. Check up when the hatch is open. You only want to check the hatch. Nobody's in a rat corner. You know, check garage briefly. No one's really, it's pretty easy to spot someone. You kind of drone up to this point. You don't need drone in there that too much, because you want to get in as fast as you can. Remember, hatches are closed. Go in. You have probably the advantage because you have peeker's advantage, you're a 3-speed, and you have that Habana ACOG. You're gonna be like, yo, you're swinging on this guy. And knowing with the holographic, it's gonna be very hard for them to see you when you have that ACOG. They're gonna be like, oh, I'm gonna try to kill you. You're gonna get that headshot on them. So, when it's very quick, you wanna catch these guys off guard, because if you can get this open real quick, you really stir up the enemy defense. So, you go here, you do the middle right here. It doesn't have to be exact, but watch how your Habana pellets, you know, look, they can kind of split off like that. But usually, generally, you want to go straight down the middle and spam your button. get that open. At this point, you're getting ready. Either you're holding the angle, which I don't recommend doing sometimes because some people might just pre-fire your butt. And then watch out for angles like Vigil or like a Cav. You might, like, maybe like halfway during the round, you might get jump scared. You hear an impact right here. Usually, this is a, you want to change up your ankles, you know, like, just like, boom here. If that hatch is not closed, get ready, start droning yourself, and watch out for this hatch too. This hatch could open up. Usually, dash had a, it doesn't get open up that much, but if you hear the impact right there, maybe like drone yourself behind this right area. But, or if that, if not, then I usually go like right here, the drone, if both these are open. But you know, the roamer is the chances of a roamer getting you this, like two roamers at your ones, are very, very low in ranked. And maybe you have someone, but like, you kind of have to just outgun them at that point and just get the hatch drop. If they both drop the hatch, then it's well played on their part. You should not be mad. The strat is not bad, but you know, they just counter-stratted you. But if they have two people in here, then your teammates are probably pushing the other garage, and it's just very unlikely to happen. So don't overthink what's going to happen. Like, don't overthink how is this going to get counter-pushed. Obviously, you want to think that, but you don't want to, you know, you don't want to not believe in yourself. So once you have this open, people are going to scatter. They're going to like, oh, what the heck? This is getting open. Watch out. They're going to be in here. This is 99% of the time not reinforced unless there's a mirror. This is reinforced. They're going to be hiding right here. They're going to be scared for the life. They're going to be like, oh, I don't know where to go. Once someone's in here, it's basically a 4v5. They're doing nothing unless they like peek out right here. But then, you know, boom, you get them. A common spot you're going to find most people are the mirror, right, to rotation right here. They can't see them right here. Or right, someone might be behind a hole in the bomb right here. They're trying to peek you, but you're gonna be like, all the way back there. People are rotating. People in the connector, these are just free kills right here. People in the connector are gonna be like, oh, gotta smoke off, and you can get shot. It's just, this is such a powerful angle. You get line of sight to basically the whole site. You get this whole back wall. Considering this garage here is the most powerful angle on this site, in my opinion. Considering the garage. The garage, you only see this. This is 99% of the time reinforced. Now, this is just solely a back push. You could basically throw up the whole any defense by yourself. Your whole team could push over here. I mean, obviously, you might not get the trade, but it's this is what you do most of the solo queue. You get this open, and then once you get, maybe you might be able to get a pick. Be careful, sometimes, you know, people might be peeking you, and they might actually land a shot on you, because it's not that hard to see you sometimes. You like to pre-fire this spot right here, you get the free headshot. I'll show you guys in a clip of me doing it later. You know, like here. People like to hide, Echoes to pull up a shield, like to hide right here. Yeah, be careful right here. So, basically, what you're doing, I don't know if you guys understand, but just a solo queue, you gotta do as much as you can to win the round. Not fragging out, not be like, oh, how can I rush the side as Ash and knife the floor, boom, 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 headshot, headshot, headshot. No, you wanna, simple, don't overthink it. You wanna be simple, you wanna win the round by, you know, making the enemy play your game. They have to play to your Hibana holes now. They have to play under your hatch. They have to play on you. Like, when you're as Hibana and Buck, you just make so many angles and you make it harder for them to defend. You want to make it unique and that they won't know how to defend it. So, all right, let's go to the next bomb site. I'm not going to do games. I'm just going to do master. That's probably it. We're going to the master bedroom now. Most of the time, nobody goes up here unless they won both spots. And if they won both spots, if you're down in O2, don't worry about it. So, you know, usually I bring my drone same spot as we do for the garage. This is a very good spot for attackers to go in, because you go from the white garage or go from master. So you just run this way, shoot out default cam, and then you pick up your drone. Always watch out for this, and then run out right there. Pick up this, go up here. So the main goal on this site is either not so much to get frags, but to go for the plant. Now, it may not be a bad idea to go on top of the rock. Once you kind of, like, at spawn, you could go on the top of the rock and maybe get a few kills, try to get a few kills. But you want to, 100% of the time, want to drone this out. If you don't drone this out, you could get killed by a pixel bullet hole doc right here, you know. Oh, what is he doing here? Why is nobody killing him? you know, drown yourself out. Don't get yourself killed by your own info. You have drones. So you draw a bathroom. Someone might be having a bathroom. They have a rotation. Now, this site is just so easy to attack. There's windows in every single room. Like, two windows in every single room. Like, bathroom. You got this one, this one, this one, this one. Everywhere. Like, the whole main lobby is windowed off. So once that's clear, I usually like to keep these barricaded off for a bit and then, you know, shoot them down. So once they're shot down, you want to stand like here, or you can just go prone right here. You're pretty safe right here. You want to drone again. Always, always, always drone. Drone until you don't have any more drones. And then, you know, you kind of just face it. You might get shot right here. I usually like to just go through the rotation. You're like, okay, there's only one guy. There's a rookie guy in sight. If there's nobody in here, but you see like Echo Cam, Val Cam, try to get rid of those first. And then if there's a guy in here, just go tell us, just try to, it's just like, yeah, I don't know where else your teammates would be. Like at the bathroom window, just windows. If someone's going up the stairs, then they're, I don't know what they're doing. Some people might do a library push, but in my opinion, library pushes are harder just because you have to basically go through their quote unquote defense first. And it's more of a firefight, gunfight there. Right here, yeah, let's say that there's a rotation right here. Most of the time, there's not gonna be mirrors, so I'm not gonna worry about that. But if there's a mirror, you will have smokes. Let's say the rotation's right here, right? So, as gridlock, or if you don't have gridlock, you go with smokes. One of the smokes, maybe jackal. You don't even have to have smokes. Just, you know, this is mostly just try to get the plant down. Maybe even a Monty. Someone. You know, you could like face your back right here. So what I usually like to do, I like to smoke off the main door and then smoke off this right here. Now this, the bathroom, is not really a problem because this smoke goes into the rotation. So at this point, people are probably going to either this door or bathroom rotate, but you know, I have someone on this window, or maybe you just have someone covering you, like rappelling right there. And then either you can jump in right here, but you're kind of exposed to this. A good plant spot is right here, pretty safe. You know, start planting. Ask your team to cover you, they'll probably see you. Or, you know, maybe while it's smoking, you could just do it right here. While it's smoking, and then, oh, I forgot to tell you to use your gridlocks. So, I usually just, you know, just toss a gridlock right there. You could try a Kobe one in there. Toss one in here. You kind of want to gridlock these before you smoke off. Yeah, you want to like, you can do it at the same time, but you know, your gun's down and you might get caught, your pants down. And then if you can, maybe Kobe one in there. While they're busy shooting that, you're already smoking off, you're getting the plant down. And you get the plant down, you win the round. Now, you're gonna be like, what if my teammates, oh, we did this and my teammates died after the plant. Well, that means they weren't holding the right angles. Now, after this, people either like, you know, you get safe to run out, but you be careful facing your back to them, because yeah, it's just not good to face your back. You just get up, you aim here, and then you just, you know, yeah, if you want, just pre-fire yourself, and then you get behind here. Or if you're safe enough, you can have a teammate go behind here, hold the angle of the rotation. Like, it's very hard to see them. If you have time, I don't know, you don't want to face your back against them, but you know, hold the anchor here. The diffuser's right here. There's so many ways. You can go to the top of the rock. I don't know if you're, it's like anywhere. You basically win the round. Alright. So that's basically it for the chalet attack. The upstairs for dining and kitchen trophy, I use Hibana. Same thing downstairs for Hibana. For a snowmobile, and for upstairs, I use gridlock or just some sort of flex op. You don't have to worry about hard breach too much. Hibana is a good pick. You could take out the, but you don't want to give angles until you know where you're planting. So, thank you guys for watching this attack video. If I did miss anything, please let me know. But I do try to upload these kind of like, you know, these attack and defense tips every day. If you guys want to see me play live, you know, have a good time with my other subs. I'm live, you will see on the screen. My Instagram, I post almost every day, you know, maybe a meme or two, and just stream highlights. If you guys don't wanna, if you wanna see more stream highlights, then I might upload some on YouTube, but you know, we'll go from there. So I appreciate y'all for clicking on this video. It means a lot. I am trying out this new solo series. So yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video tomorrow. Maybe we'll do some defense, or it kind of depends on the comments and how Twitch chat tells me. Yeah, we can do defense or offense. Please feel free to comment below what kind of map and what side you want to see. And if you want to see other kind of tip videos like this, just like this game knowledge you don't really know in general, please let me know in the comments. And if feel free, please correct me if I am missing out on anything, if I misspell, if I miss out on a common angle, you know, like, oh, what if this happens, you know, just let me know. It's easier to ask me when I'm streaming on Twitch. I stream almost every day. It's easier to type a message on there, and you get more feedback from me. Or, you know, you can hit up maybe someone else, like another pro player. But thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.
I'm trying to change the world. Maybe you touch some diamonds and pearls. Yeah. I usually have an answer.